गुड आफ्टरनून जी। इन द मॉर्निंग सेशन वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट डिटर्मिनेंट्स, इजंट इट? डिटर्मिनेंट ऑफ अ 3x3 मैट्रिक्स एंड 2x2 मैट्रिक्स। डिटर्मिनेंट ऑफ अ 3x3 मैट्रिक्स एंड 2x2 मैट्रिक्स। सो चिल्ड्रन, नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न वन इंपॉर्टेंट टर्म कॉल्ड cofactor of a matrix, cofactor and minor. So write the heading, minor and cofactor, from this part and all you can expect so many one mark question. Okay, minor and cofactor is an important part from where you will get so many one mark question. Okay, what is meant by minor? Minor means
a person who is below 18 years of age.
Okay. So here, what about determinants? What is meant by minor? What you are going to do? Minor means smaller, isn't it? So given a matrix, we are going to write another smaller matrix by removing the row and column. That is what we call it as minor of a matrix. Okay, minor of a matrix means it is a submatrix. Listen, children, you can write afterwards. It is a submatrix. It is a submatrix got by removing a row and column. Okay, for example, look at here. We can define minor of each element. Okay, first we can learn the example. After that, we can generalize it. Okay, suppose A is equal to matrix 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, 2, 3, 4, 5. I'll write a 3x3 matrix. Then you can understand it easily. So A is equal to matrix 2, 3, -3, 4, 5, 2, and 9, 6, 7. Suppose I want to find the minor of the element 3. Listen, children, minor of the element. What you have to do? Okay, in order to write the minor, you leave the row and column containing that element. So three is in this row and column. So leave this row and column. Are you getting a 2x2 matrix? Okay, write that matrix. You leave the row and column. So minor of 3 is 4, 2, 9, 7. Minor of an element is another determinant. You'll be getting a determinant by leaving this row and column containing 3. Is it okay? Like this, we can define minor for each and every element. Okay, minor. Okay, if it is a for square matrix only we can define determinants. So we go with always square matrix. So minor of an element, is a determinant. Minor of an element is a determinant. Okay, minor of an element is a determinant. Okay, by removing the row and column containing the element. We remove this row and column containing that element. So tell me, Karthik, what is minor of 7? What will be minor of 7?
Ma'am, 2, 3, 4, 5.
2, 3, 4, 5. We can find the value. We know how to find the value of a determinant, isn't it? So here it is 28 - 18, we get 10. Here 10 - 12, which is -2. Okay. Is it clear, children? This minor. Okay, how we find the minor? Is it okay? Now let's learn the definition. Okay, let's learn the definition now. So let's capital A is equal to matrix A I J B N m by m square matrix. Suppose A is equal to matrix A I J B matrix of order m by m. Let capital A is equal to matrix A I J. Be a square matrix of order m by m, where m is greater than or equal to 2. That is at least for okay. Order must be a 2x2 matrix. Then only we can define minor. Okay, if it is a 1x1 and all, we can't define minor. Only for 2x2 matrix onwards, okay, we can define minor. So let A is equal to matrix Aij be a square matrix, comma, m greater than or equal to 2. Then the determinant of, m by 1 cross m by 1 matrix, m minus 1 by m minus 1 matrix, obtained by then the determinant of order m minus 1 by m minus 1 then the
determinant,
yes, the determinant of order m minus 1 by m minus 1. Okay, why I mixed it with cross product and all means previous period I had 11th standard I was teaching cross product and all. So instead of using that word by, I used cross. Okay, so here it is. Okay, sorry, it is not cross. Here it is by, m minus 1 by m minus 1. Then the determinant of order m minus 1 by m minus 1 obtained from A. Obtained from A after deleting the ith row and jth column is called the minor of the element, is called the minor of the element Aij, is called the minor of the element Aij, is called the minor of the element Aij, and is denoted as capital Mij. And it is denoted as, look at the notation children, capital Mij, minor of the ijth element. Okay, minor of the ijth element is denoted as capital Mij. Okay, it is capital Mij. Okay, so it is a determinant of order m minus 1 by m minus 1. How we get this determinant? We remove the row and column containing that ijth element. Okay, let's look at an example. Look at this example. Suppose we have the matrix A is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Now listen, children. Okay, suppose you are asked to find m 1, 3. How you find M13? What you have to do? What is M13? It is the minor of the element A13, isn't it? It is the minor of the element A13. So A13 means first row, third column. First row, third column, what is the element there? 3, isn't it? It is same as minor of 3. How will you get minor of 3? You remove this row and column containing this element 3. So So leave this row, leave this column. What you will get? This determinant 4, 5, 7, 8, which is 32 minus 35, which is minus 3. Is it okay? Is it okay, children? Aparna, Karthik?
Yes, ma'am.
Karthik?
Yes, ma'am.
Shubham? Aditya? Okay, suppose the question is find M22. Okay, the same matrix. With the same matrix, let's practice. Okay, let's practice this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Find M22. What is the answer? Tomlin, give the answer. Tomlin, M22 means? It is second row, second column. So it is the minor of the element?
5.
So it is the minor of the element 5?
4, 6, 7, 9.
No.
No, 1, 3, 9.
Yes. Okay. So see, leave this. So we will get. And this determinant 1, 3, 7, 9, and it is 9 minus 21. What is the answer, Aishwarya?
-12.
So find M32. Find M32. Find M32. Minor of third row, second column. Minor of third row, second column. That will be same as third row, second column. Anila?
Yes.
Minor of M. Okay, minor of dash.
4, 7, 6, 9.
4, 7, 6, 9. How will you get 4, 7, 6, 9? M32. Third row, second column. So which one you should remove? M32 means first you locate the element. Which is the element? Which element? It is minor of? Third row, second column means, is it minor of 8?
Yes.
So we should remove this row and column, isn't it?
Yes.
Therefore, what you will get?
1, 4, 3, 6.
1, 4. Okay. So it is determinant 1, 4, 3, 6. 1, 4. Okay, along the 1, 4, 3, 6. Now, what is the answer? It is 6 minus 12, which is negative 6. Is it okay? Now, let's do this with a 2 by 2. Let us do one more question with a 2 by 2 matrix. So let A is equal to, let A is equal to matrix 2, -3, 4, 7. Find M11, M12, M21, M22. Find out M11, M12, M21, M22. A is a 2 by 2 matrix. Find M11, M12, M21, M22. what is M11? Aparna.
Ma'am, 7.
7, yes. You leave the row and column containing the first row, first element. Okay. Aishwarya, what is M12?
4.
4. Shubham? Shubham, M21. What about M21? Yes, Shubham, what is M21? Shubham, okay. Aditya, Satyan, what is M21?
Minus 3.
Anila Mohanan, M22?
Ma'am, 2.
Now is it clear, children? About this minor, is it okay? Minor, is it okay? Now, we are going to learn the next one, cofactor. Write the side heading, cofactor. Cofactor of an element. Listen, children, this notations and all, you should learn it clear. Okay, carefully, no doubt. Okay, don't write, first you listen. Let capital A is equal to matrix AIG of order M by M. Let it be a square matrix. For a square matrix only, we can define determinant. Okay. Now I'm going to define mine cofactor. Cofactor of the element AIJ. Cofactor of the element AIJ. It is denoted as capital AIJ. Listen here. Cofactor of the element small aij is denoted as capital Aij. And what is capital Aij? It is minus 1 raised to I plus j into Mij. What do you have to do? We have to find the minor. Find the minor and suffix it with minus 1 raised to I plus j. You find the minor, then you multiply it by minus 1 raised to I plus j. Okay, find the minor and multiply it with minus 1 raised to I plus j. Okay, so cofactor of an element small aij is denoted as capital Aij. And what is capital Aij? Capital Aij is minus 1 raised to I plus j into Mij. Okay, for example, children, for example, look at here. This is for your understanding. I'm giving this example. Suppose capital A is equal to matrix A1, A2, A3, B1, B2, B3, C1, C2, C3. Okay, so listen. Okay, this is the given matrix. So I'm finding the minor, okay, I'm finding the minor and I'm representing the minor of all the elements. What is the minor? Minor of A1 will be denoting it as capital M1. How will you find the minor? We leave the row and column. We'll get one value. Similarly, for the second element, it is M2. Third element, it is M3. You can use the notation, the 1, 1, then only it will be clear for you. Suppose A is the matrix A11, A12, A13, A21, A22, A23, A31, A32, A33. So minor of this element, we denote this as M11. Here it is M12, M13, M21, M22, M23. M31. So we can find the minor of all the elements like this. We can find the minor of all the elements. Now, what do you have to do with this minor? I'm going to multiply the sign. with MIJ, I should add minus 1 raised to I plus J. For the first one, I is 1, J is 1. So here we will get M11. But look at the next case. 1 plus 2, it is 3. So we'll get minus M12. Look at the next one. 1 plus 3, it is 4. So minor will be same as, okay. So here I am writing the cofactor. Okay, I am writing the cofactor. Cofactor of the element will be, for the first row, first column, it will be same as the minor. But for the second element, the cofactor will be minus M12. Why? Cofactor is defined as minus 1 raised to I plus J. So 1 plus 2, it is 3, odd number. So we'll get minus. But first row, third column, it will be plus itself. Okay, that is why today morning I gave one form here. Plus, minus, plus. What about the next one? M21, here it will be minus. Okay, here it will be plus M22. And here M23, M31, minus M32, plus M33. So this is how we get the cofactor. First find the minor of each element. With that element, you multiply by minus or plus. Based on the value, minus 1 raised to I plus J. Based on the value, I plus J. That is, when you add this position, if it is an even number, it will be same as minor. Cofactor will be same as minor. If the position value, if you add the position value and if you are getting an even number, cofactor will be same as minus MIJ. When we add the suffix and if it is an even number. Is it clear, children? Are you able to understand? Karthik? Aparna?
Yes.
Let's do one question and once again we can look into the definition. Okay. Now look at this. Write the question. What is that sound? So look at the question, write this. Delta is equal to determinant 7, 4, minus 1, 2, 3, 0, 1, minus 5, 2. Find M12, A12, M13, A13, M23, A23. Okay. So first let us find out M12. What is M12? Minor of first row, second element. What is minor of first row, second element? Minor of first row, second element. So first row, second element. What is the element we have there? First row, second element means 4, isn't it? If you leave that row and column, we get determinant 2012. Is it correct, Aditya, Tomlin?
Yes, ma'am.
So when you expand it, we get this as 4. Now, what is A12? Listen, children, what is A12? Minus 1 raised to 1 plus 2 into M12. Minus 1 raised to 1 plus 2 into M12, which is same as minus M12, which is equal to minus 4. So whenever the position value, when you add the position, it is an odd number. Look at here, the sign is changing. If it is plus 4, we are getting minus 4. Now look at the next one, M13. What will be M13? What is M13? What is M13? First row, third column. Yes, Karthik, give me what is M13?
Determinant 2, 3, 1, negative 5.
So that is equal to value minus 10 minus 3, which is negative 13, isn't it? So what will be A13? It is minus 1 raised to 1 plus 3 into M13. So it is an even number. So it is same as M13. Okay, it is same as M13, which is negative 13. Now find out M23 and A23. M23, you try this and find out what is A23. What is the answer? What is M23? Aditya Satyan? Aditya?
Yes, ma'am.
What is M23?
7, 4, 1, -5.
7, 4, 1, -5. And what is the value?
-39.
-39. And what will be A23? Karthik.
Ma'am, 39.
39. Is it okay, children? Do you get how to find the minor and cofactor? Are you getting the idea how to find the minor and cofactor? Is it clear? Is it okay? Hmm? Tomlin, Anila, Aditya?
Yes, ma'am.
Hmm?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so now we are going to relate it with a determinant. Okay, now we are going to relate it with determinant. Once again, we can start with a 3x3 determinant. Okay. So listen, don't write. First listen, children. A is equal to, suppose A is equal to matrix A11, A12, A13, A21, A22, A23. I'm taking the general form. Okay, so that you can understand the formula. A32, A33. What is capital A11? What is capital A11? It is cofactor of small a11, isn't it? It is the cofactor of small a11. So it is same as minus 1 raised to 1 plus 1 m11. Isn't it? The definition aij is minus 1 raised to I plus j into mij. Here it is an even number, so it will be same as m11. What is m11? Leave the row and column. So we get determinants a22, a23, A32, A33. For the time being, I'm not going to expand. I keep it as such. What is A12? What is A12? Minus 1 raised to 1 plus 2 into M12. So which is minus M12. It is minus M12. So which is minus first row, second column. First row, second column. So we'll get A21. A23, A31, A33. Similarly, find out what is A13. What is A13? Minus 1 raised to 1 plus 3, capital M13. It is an even number, so we get it is M13, which is determinant. A21, A22, A31, A32. Is it correct, children? Up to this, is it okay? Okay, I'll give time for copying. First, you listen, because there's an important one mark question. We are going to prove some important results, which will be asked for one mark question. Up to this, is it okay? We are writing the minor of all the elements in the first row. Minor and adjoint of all the elements in the first row. Look at here, we write all the cofactor of all the elements A11, A12, A13. Okay, now for the same determinant, I'm going to expand it. I'm going to expand it along the first row. Suppose I expand this determinant along first row, what you will get? Expanding along R1, what is delta RA? What is determinant A? A11 into, isn't it? A11 into, leave this row and column, we write A22, A23, A32, A33, minus A12 into, leave the row and column. So we get A21, A23, A31, A33, plus A13 into, leave the row and column, A21, A22, A31, A32. Now look at your children. One A11, A23, A32, A33. Is it possible to replace with capital A11? Is it correct? Same way, look at the next one. A12, taking this negative along with this 2 by 2, we can write this as plus a capital A12. How? This minus and this one we can combine. Look at the second one. It is it capital A12 minus of A21, A23, A31, A33. Again, plus A13 into capital A13. So this is same as the determinant. So if we expand it along first row, we will get like this. If we expand it along first row, we'll get like this. From here, what is the result we are proving? Listen, what is the result we are proving? Okay, sum of, listen children, sum of products. Sum of products of any row. You can take it along row or any column. Sum of product of any row or column with its corresponding cofactor. With its corresponding cofactor. When you multiply it by the corresponding cofactor, an element multiplied by the corresponding cofactor gives the determinant by the corresponding cofactor is equal to the determinant. Is equal to the determinant. Is equal to the determinant. Okay, we take an element multiplied by corresponding cofactor plus second element, we multiply by its corresponding cofactor plus third element in the first row with the corresponding cofactor. So it is equal to determinant. The sum of product of any row with its corresponding cofactor is equal to determinant. Otherwise, if you change the order, it will be zero. Otherwise, the value of the determinant is zero. We'll get the other case. In other cases and all, it will be zero. The determinant value will become zero. Everything will get canceled. Otherwise, that value will be zero. Okay, no need to write the determinant. Otherwise, the value is zero. In which case we will get the determinant? If you multiply an element by its corresponding cofactor. An element multiplied by its corresponding cofactor will be equal to delta. Delta means determinant. Okay, delta means it is determinant. That A, D-E-T, that A, three ways are there for representing. You copied this one, children, from the beginning. I'll show it. Those who are not copied, copy this one. Okay, this is what we get when we expand along the first row. Okay, we get this value when we expand it along first row. Similarly, we can do it along second row, third row. We can do it along the first column, second column, or third column. So when you complete this, tell me, children. You can write that your notes. Up to this, is it okay? Is it okay, Tomlin, Aishwarya?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
And you finished writing, Tomlin?
No, ma'am.
No. Okay. Okay. When you finish this one, please tell me. Okay, we have tried the next point. That is very important point. Shubham. 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 Shubham, finished writing, Shubham? Are you there?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, tomorrow you have to send the data, okay, regarding that project. Okay, send the data tomorrow. Is it over? Aishwarya, copying, is it over?
Yes, ma'am.
Anila? Anila? Yes. Aparna, I think she's copying. Finished?
Ma'am, 1 minute.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Okay, children, now look at this note. So we know that the determinant of a matrix can be calculated using rows or columns, isn't it? Suppose A is equal to matrix Aij, A11, A12, A13, A21, A22, A23, and A31, A32, A33. So listen. Delta is same as determinant A. It is same as det A. We can write this in 6 ways using this cofactor. So first one is along the first row, A11, capital A11, plus A12, capital A12, plus A13, capital A13. That is along the first row. Similarly, if you take along the second row, A21, capital A21, plus A22, capital A22 plus A23, capital A23. That is, this is the case we will get when we expand it along the second row. If we expand along third row, we will get A31, capital A31, plus A32, capital A32, plus A33, capital A33. Or if you expand along the first column, A11, capital A21, plus A11. Then A21, capital A21, plus A31, capital A31. Or second column, if you take small A12, capital A12, A22, plus capital A22, plus A32, capital A32. Similarly, if you take the third row, third column, A13, capital A13, plus A23, capital A23, plus small A33, capital A33. Okay, so in this case, we'll be getting the value as delta. Suppose I mix it and write like this, small A1 with capital A12, plus A12 with capital A22, plus A13 with capital A13, means in other cases, the value will be zero. Only in these six cases, okay, in the six cases, we'll be getting the value of the determinant. So this one will be asked, okay, you'll be given an option like this, and you may be asked with the four values, four options will be given. You have to select, okay, what is the statement? If you mark the sum of product of an element with its corresponding cofactor will be equal to the determinant. The sum of products of an element of a row, or if you can take it along column also, with its corresponding cofactor is equal to the value of the determinant. Is equal to the value of the determinant. Is it clear, children? Okay, I think we can do problems in the next class, and we can start with the next job. Okay. I think 4 more minutes are there. Any doubt in this topic? Is it okay regarding the determinants? Is it okay? Is it okay, children? Any doubt? Okay. How to find the value of the determinant? Now, let's do one question now, right now. Write the question. Evaluate determinant cos 90 minus cos 45 sin 90 sin 45. Although we say trigonometric functions are not there, this function we have learned in our 10th standard, isn't it? So we can be, we'll be asked with some questions like this. We know the value still 90. What is cos 90? What is cos 90? Value of cos 90 is 0. What is cos 45? You see who is will be giving the answer. It is 1 by root 2. Cos 45 and sin 45 are 1 by root 2. Sin 90? 1. Sin 45 in 1 by root 2. This 1 by root 2. Now evaluate this and give the answer. What is the answer? What is the value of the determinant? What is the answer, Aishwarya?
1 by root 2.
Yes, 1 by root 2 is the answer. Okay. 1 by root 2. Sin 0 is 0. Sin 30? 1 by 2 sin 30 1 by 2 sin 30 will be same as cos 60 sin 30 same as cos 60 sin 0 sin 0 0 okay okay children this I end the session now in the next class we can continue with the properties of determinants thank you